stampers, and welcome to Laura's Stamp Pad. Again, because the holidays are just right around the corner, I thought I would share with you another gift packaging idea. So be sure to check out my one that I posted last week, and then you can see even more gift packaging ideas. So this week, I'm going to show you a little bag. Since last week we did a box, I thought I would do a little gift bag this week. I am super loving these cafe bags that Stampin' Up! Has in the holiday mini catalog. They are super fabulous, perfect size for any little treat, and the best part is they are actually plastic lined. So if you have any goodies that maybe are a little greasy or a little sugary, or you're afraid they're gonna come out the corners or something, then you don't have to worry about that because this little plastic lining will actually prevent it from, you know, the grease leaking through or making any messes. So your packaging will look super fabulous no matter what you put inside of it. So let's get started on how I created this adorable little treat bag with the super fabulous little stars. So I just took the cafe bag, and I actually have it where it opens to the front. So the little tab is laying on the back, and it opens to the front, and I'm using one of my decorative masks. This mask was actually from the Stars and Hearts. There's also one that is stripes and dots, but I'm using the one from the Stars and Hearts, and I'm also using one of my Whisper White ink pad. And with the ink pad, I am using, of course, one of my little sponge daubers. You know how I love sponge daubers. So I'm just going to lay this mask down and kind of pounce into each one of those little stars. And if you don't want as many stars, you can always omit some of them just by not pouncing on top. But I kind of find that the best way to get this done, because sometimes it feels like you're gonna be here forever, is to kind of pounce up and down and do like a little twist with your finger. So just kind of twist and pounce. And that's how you'll get all of those little stars filled in quickly and completely. Okay, and now once you have all of your stars, you can just set this aside. For cleaning this off, I find it best to use a baby wipe, but you can also use a wet paper towel underneath some running water as well, and just kind of wipe it clean. But in the meantime, be sure not to make a mess with this. So now you have those fabulous little stars that graduate as it goes up. You will want to set this aside for just a little bit because, of course, the Whisper White ink is a craft ink, so it is a little bit more time consuming with the drying, but no worries there. Just set this aside while you work on your tag, and it'll be dry once you're done. So I'm gonna set that aside, and I won't actually complete that one, but I will whenever I post it on my blog, so be sure to check that out for photos. For the little tag that I used here, I actually used a piece of scrap Whisper White cardstock and then a little bit of Mossy Meadow, and the greeting says celebrate the season, and I used that from the Endless Wishes stamp set, which is also in the holiday mini catalog. So there's many different greetings that you could pair together to make the perfect little greeting, and then I stamped just a few little snowflakes a few different times to get those varying shades of blue, some lighter, some darker. So you can see that there. And then I wrapped ribbon completely around it. This is the satin stitched ribbon in Lost Lagoon in one of the new in colors. So I absolutely love that. And then you'll see I actually just attached this with one of the little metallic clothespins. So that's just right there. You can always just take the little clothespin off, untie your ribbon, and get your goodies outside of your box. So just kind of put this right on there and then snap it right onto the ribbon. So super quick and simple there. You can always add different colors here, other in colors or anything else. And then you have that adorable gift bag there. How cute is that? Quick and simple and absolutely fabulous. Be sure to check out my blog next week for another amazing tutorial on some gift packaging ideas. And don't forget to check out my blog to see the finished one over there. I think I'm gonna do it with some Blackberry Bliss because that's one of my favorite colors right now. So don't forget to check that out. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you like it, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss next week's video. Happy stamping. Bye-bye.